Hello everyone, welcome to today's class. Today we will discuss about the topic osmosis. Before starting the topic, we need to know about membrane. So what is membrane? We can define it as a thin sheet of tissue or layer of cells acting as the boundary, lining or partition in an organism. We can see it in the cell membrane or outside the organelles. Next is the types. First one is impermeable membrane, the plastic or polythene, then the cuticle of leaves, which made up of cutin, is impermeable because it doesn't allow any solute or solvent to pass. Second type is permeable membrane. The cell wall is a permeable membrane because the cell wall is made up of hydrophilic colloidal substances. While the cutin is impermeable, the cell wall is permeable. Next is semi-permeable membrane. The cell wall is permeable, but the cell membrane below the cell wall is impermeable because the phospholipid bilayer or the structure of semi-permeable cell membrane allows only the solvent to pass. Now what will happen if we separate two solution of different concentration with a semi-permeable membrane? The result will be the movement of solvent through the semi-permeable membrane to the higher concentration region from the low concentration region. So that is our topic today, osmosis. We can define osmosis as a process by which molecules of a solvent tend to pass through a semi-permeable membrane from a less concentrated solution into a more concentrated one. As example, if we put cells into the distilled water, that is pure water, the water will get inside the cells and the cells will swell and burst. Again, if we place the cells in the concentrated solution, then the water will come out of the cells and the cells will shrink. Why osmosis occurs? The reason is osmotic pressure. What is it? It is the tendency of solvent molecules to move in the direction of lower solvent activity. We can also define it as the osmotic pressure which needs to be applied to a solution to prevent the inward flow of its pure solvent across a semi-permeable membrane. By using this mechanism, if we give pressure greater than the osmotic pressure, then the water moves from the high concentration to the low concentration region and we get purified water. This mechanism is called reverse osmosis process. So we can tell that osmosis is a specific type of diffusion because here, the passage of water from a region of high concentration occurs through a semi-permeable membrane to a region of low water concentration. So, if we compare between diffusion and osmosis, both wants to equalize the concentration of two solutions, but diffusion allows only both the solvent and solute particles, while the osmosis allows only the solvent particles. Diffusion involves no semi-permeable membrane and osmosis involves the movement through a semi-permeable membrane. Now, what is the importance of osmosis? The first importance lies in the water absorption in roots. As the cell sap inside the root hairs is higher concentration, so water enters inside it through osmosis, and this osmosis water enters finally into the xylem through endosmosis process. Next one is the absorption of minerals in roots. This can occur through passive diffusion or osmosis along with the water. Otherwise, it can be active absorption that needs ATP. Next, osmosis can maintain the turgidity of the cell. When osmosis water enters inside the cell becomes swollen. In this process, osmosis helps to maintain turgidity in the plant stem and the plant remains fresh. Again, osmosis plays role in the stomata opening and stomata closing. When the water enters into the cell, that is GERD cells, the cells become swollen and the stomata opens. Again, when water leaves the GERD cells through osmosis, the cells become shrunken and the stomata closes. It also plays an important role in the opening and closing of petals. Because of sugar accumulation inside the cell vacuole, water gets inside it through osmosis and the petals become opened. Here we can see the small intestine of animals. We have villi, that is the folded region in our small intestine. In this region, the microvilli, nutrient, minerals and vitamins are absorbed by osmosis process. So we can summarize, the significance of osmosis is entry of water, cell-to-cell diffusion or transportation, maintaining turgidity, water absorption in the kidneys, and intestinal absorption. So finally, we can say that osmosis is very important process not only for the biological systems but for another systems also, like purification of drinking water or industrial applications. We can also determine the molar masses, especially those of polymers. So these are other uses of osmosis. So thank you all for today.